Thanks for listening to the Style Split Answers for the final exam. The final exam will cover the following styles: Placket Style, Art Deco, Suprematism Constructivism, which will be one item on the test. You don't have to split the styles between those two. De Stijl, Bauhaus and the New Typography are also one item on the exam. Modern Movement in America, International Typographic Style, the New York School, Corporate Identity and Visual Systems, Conceptual Image, and the Digital Revolution and Postmodern Design, along with its substyles, are all one item on the exam. So, in reviewing our very first slide, this is clearly corporate identity. Here we see a classic example of Placket Style with the name of the product, a flat background color, and a dominant stylized image. Here we see that classic indicator of De Stijl, the primary colors of blue, yellow, and red with neutrals and those perpendicular lines. Even though it says Bauhaus, don't let that fool you. This is De Stijl. Okay, next we have another great example of the Placket Style. In this particular example, that Cyrillic alphabet where the lettering looks Soviet influenced is really giving us a clue that we're looking at constructivism because we see recognizable objects. Here we have corporate identities once again. Now in this example, we see clearly the modern movement in America. There's the Bauhaus influence, but we see that American content. And in this example, we've got a great version of the Bauhaus. Whenever you see Olympic graphics, you know you're in the corporate identity and visual systems category. Now remember that De Stijl can be also chairs or furniture. It could also be interiors or exteriors. Again, we see those primary colors and those horizontal and vertical lines, but in an interior. These posters for the national parks are great examples of the modern movement in America. Remember, you'll see that Bauhaus influence with the American content and WPA typography, often for social programs. When it looks like an abstract painting, you know that you're looking at suprematism. There won't be any other chapters on the final exam that do that. So suprematism looks like a piece of fine art. All right, again, Olympic graphics tell us we're in corporate identity and visual systems. Here we see narrative information communicated with ideas and concepts in the familiar, in an unfamiliar setting, like that cigar, that shoe that becomes a house that people are walking up to. This is the conceptual image. Here's a great example of a retro vernacular piece, which is postmodern design. We see that eclectic modernist European design of the first half of the century. And this gives us a clue as to what we're looking at, which is postmodern design, retro vernacular. Here we see another great example of digital revolution, postmodern design. We see that computer-generated imagery that is going on and that intuitive, expressive typography. More corporate identities for corporate identity and visual systems. This poster is in Polish, and so we know we are looking at the conceptual image. It's going to be Polish, it's going to be German, it's going to be from the U.S., or Cuba primarily. In this particular example, we see the New York School with its emphasis on shape and that playful, visually dynamic and unexpected use of the bicycle tires combining with the typography to spell go out. This is a great example of the conceptual image for Poppy Records. This poppy is breaking through this block of concrete, which represents the monolithic conventions of the recording industry. It's really conceptual. We see computer-generated imagery telling us we're in the digital revolution postmodern design category. Horizontal and vertical lines, those primary colors, let us know we're into style. Again, here we see that Bauhaus influence, right? But it says New York World's Fair, so it's American content. This is the modern movement in America. Okay, when we see computer-generated imagery, the internet, interactive design, or the World Wide Web, we're in the digital revolution, postmodern design category for the test. Here we see a great example of Art Deco. We see those geometric shapes and those different influences, including the typography, which looks very deco. A great example with the Cyrillic alphabet of constructivism. The lettering looks Soviet influenced. There's diagonal lines in it, which are very characteristic of constructivism. And it often uses red and black with a beige colored background. In this piece, it says de style. So again, we see those horizontal and verticals, and the type is even in there. It looks like an abstract painting. It's got to be suprematism. Here we see another great example of the conceptual image for the Day of the Heroic Guerrilla, with Che radiating over an outline of South America. So again, the conceptual image. In this next image, we clearly see a beautiful Art Deco poster created by A.M. Cassandra. We see that beautiful typography with the streamline and converging lines going on. Now, furniture that looks like this, or teapots and things, are the Bauhaus. So we can totally see that function, not decoration, that purity, that clarity, and that simplicity. Another great example, in Bad Breath by Seymour Quast, of the conceptual image, a piece that is condemning the bombing of Hanoi with Uncle Sam turning green. A great example of the modern movement in America with a social program, the Rural Electrification Administration, giving it away. Olympics, again, we're in corporate identity and visual systems. Okay, obviously the type is in the black letter font. It's a war poster for a war loan. This is going to be Plocketstil. All right, it's a chair, but we see again those primary colors, horizontals and verticals. It's de style. This next piece for Deutsche Lufthansa is obviously a war-related poster. It's Plocketstil. Again, this piece says de style, so it's pretty clear what you're looking at. A very wonderful conceptual image poster where the continent of Africa is made like a blood stain, putting the familiar in an unfamiliar setting. It's also in German. Here we see a good example of the importance of shape. It's got to be the New York School. You've got a uniquely American approach with your origins in European modernism. It's playful, it's visually dynamic and unexpected, and that use of shape is big. An advertising poster in the Plocketstil. And here we see the corporate identity again, and visual systems chapter. A beautiful piece by M. Cassandra for Dumanet. It's a classic Art Deco piece. Again, those primary colors, it's de style. All right, we see the Bauhaus influence, but the American content, and it's for a social program, it's modern movement in America. This particular piece is clearly computer generated, so it's digital revolution, postmodern design, and here we have corporate identities once again. Another great New York School piece by Paul Rand, where the use of shape helps give it away. Again, we see that uniquely American approach. Here's a piece with the Cyrillic alphabet, that red and black on a beige colored background. We have recognizable objects, so we're looking at constructivism. Again, shape is so essential to the way this poster communicates. It's New York School. All right, and here we see another great example of a conceptual image logo where it looks like graffiti or people marching in the streets and a little bit like blood. This is for the Solidarity Movement. All right, and in this next piece, we see the Bauhaus. We see that very functional, not decorated, the purity and the clarity, the simplicity, but also we see those new approaches to photography where you have extreme scale contrast, bird's eye or worm's eye. Red, blue, and yellow, and the whites, blacks, give it away, the horizontal and verticals as de style. Again, this is Bauhaus. It obviously says it right in the piece. Here we've got a piece for Rural Electrification Administration, WPA programs. This has got to be modern movement in America. A classic Art Deco poster. And here we see that geometric shapes, again, that streamlining, that lengthening going on. A really good example of the conceptual image in a poster, how many Dadaists became surrealists, and the word real is isolated on that table. All right, we see the Cyrillic alphabet, but the shapes tell us that it is suprematism because it's non-representational and it's basic geometric shapes. Plocketsteel posters. Suprematism, once again, that non-representational looks like a piece of fine art. Constructivism, the Soviet-influenced alphabet, but a recognizable object. Remember, suprematism and constructivism are the same item on the test. The streamlining going on here tells us it's Art Deco. Here's a great example of the new typography, that asymmetrical flush left, ragged right, priority assigned to text based on weight and size, with the purpose of the communication to function and not decorate. Rules are used for emphasis. Remember, the Bauhaus and the new typography are the same item on the test. It looks like a piece of fine art. It's going to be suprematism. This next piece is a simple advertising poster with the name of the product, a flat background color, and a dominant stylized image. It's plocketsteel. Shape is so important to this poster by Saul Bass. It's the New York School. And lastly, a great example of a Bauhaus communication. It's all about functioning and not decoration. Thanks for listening to this review for the final exam.